If you ask for something and you believe that when you ask it is given, is there a reason to ask again? If you're asking over and over and over again, what does that say about what you believe?
You don't really believe it's going to happen.
So can it happen under those conditions?
No.
And will continuing to ask change anything?
I don't think so.
You're the source that you're asking. In other words, you're the source energy who has become more. So again, it's the closing of the gap. So by asking, we mean focusing in a way that allows the full receiving of what you're asking for. Many people think that they do the asking with their words, or they ask for something. In other words, I'm standing over here without it and I'm asking for it. And we say, well, that it's fair to say that I've asked for it. And many think that that's the point of creation, that asking for it is what creates it. And we say asking for it does create it in the sense that you ask and source actualizes around it, but it is the finding vibrational alignment with it that lets it in. So your creation is two parts for you: asking and allowing, wanting and believing. So when you want something and you doubt it, your doubt is keeping it from being. When you want something and you believe it, your belief is letting it be. So the reason that we encourage affirmations, the affirmation is not the step one part. The affirmation is actually the step three part. Because as you say the affirmation, as you say it, reaching for a feeling, and say it, reaching for a feeling, you train yourself in to the expectation of what you're asking for.
Okay.
You see how it works?
Yes.
So a lot of people, a lot of people will offer an affirmation, and it just becomes a sort of repetitive thing that actually reinforces their awareness that what they want hasn't happened yet. A lot of people are saying things, and when they say them, it just reminds them that it hasn't happened. And they've been saying it for so long that it's almost unpleasant to say it again. And we say, that kind of affirmation is of no value. Sort of like the prayer we were talking about earlier. If you pray from a place of focusing upon the outcome that you seek, now you're in alignment with what you seek and your prayer can be realized. If you pray from your awareness of your problem, you're not a vibrational match to your solution and it can't come. So an affirmation is only as valuable as the way it feels to you. If an affirmation taunts you, stop it. If the affirmation buoys you, then say it. Esther said it every day and still does. I, Esther Hicks, see and draw to me through divine love those beings who seek enlightenment through my process. And the sharing will elevate us both now. And every time Esther says it, she feels the thrill of it, because it resonates with everything that she is, everything that she has been, everything that she strives to be. In other words, it's such a deep affirmation. It will never become a da 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 kind of affirmation. It always has meaning to her. She reaches for the words because she wants to invoke the meaning and the feeling of the words. That's an affirmation. Affirming the way I want to feel, affirming what's in my vibrational escrow, affirming who I really am, and saying it until every part of me knows it.